Hi students, good morning. Hello. This was the thing last we did, na? Yes, good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning. The thing on the board, it is about the exponential growth curve we have finished yesterday. Isn't it? Yes. Did you write it on? Did you write the equation also? Hi, good morning, Asma. Okay, today we are going to study the last thing about the interaction which is interspecific or intraspecific, okay, in within the biotic community, right? So already we are learning about the populations in that different communities, how they interact, okay? In the biotic communities, how they interact, we have all studied now, okay? All of you are there. 47 members only are there. Was expecting more. Okay. Now let's now talk about the last part of this almost. That is about the interaction between the biotic communities between the two species, interspecific interactions of biotic community. In a population, means two living communities, how do they interact, right? They imagine there are some dogs and cats, how do they interact? That's interspecific interaction, okay? So various ways are there to interact between the two species. So that is interaction, mainly interspecific interaction. Interspecific. So we are talking about the interspecific interaction of the biotic community, the living community. Okay. So what are the ways we are going to interact between the different species? That is between, because two different species we are talking. That's what we learn in understanding interaction of two species. 90-25 and then for Sanjit. I didn't know what is 90-25. Sanjit and Gartaglila, Yen Bodhidian in order. Any question I asked about the numbers? Okay, then. Marth Bodhidian, yeah, okay. Okay, listen now. We are going to talk about the interaction between two different species of biotic community. Means two living species are there. How do they interact to survive together? Suppose in one area, you can't just only expect only dogs, you can't only expect human beings. There are all the things present. So how do they interact with each other to stay together, right? There are various ways of interactions. One is positive interaction, means both are helping each other. Means this will, one species A will help species B will help species A, together they live. It's called a positive interaction. Sometimes positive, there is a negative interaction, right? One of the species may be harming the other species. It's called the negative interaction. Means one species, whenever it enters, it will harm or kill or something, it will snatch the food or whatever it is. It will take away the second species things so that second species cannot survive properly. It's called the negative interaction. Sometimes there's a neutral interaction. This means both of them are living happily without even bothering about each other. That is, they're not much depending on each other. They can survive on their own. That's called the neutral interaction. So we have three types of interactions. One is positive interaction. Second is a negative interaction. Third is a neutral interaction. Means not bothered. They'll be on their own. They'll be happy on their own. Right? Understood? So what for the interactors? Mainly for the food, for the shelter. And if in, within the species only, there'll be fight for the breeding. But interspecific breeding will not happen. So for breeding, there is no fight, right? But interspecifically, if they have the same common food, they will fight. Either one become predator, one become the prey, or both of them, they act on the same competition will be there. Or one eat other, it's a parasitism. One will live on another, there's saprophytism, that is on the saprophytes that live on another, that is a saprophytic, dead-end decaying matter. So like that, one on the other, they will interact for the same food, or they will be for the shelter, or there will be for water, whatever it is. There will be a kind of interaction happening between the two biotic species. So that's what we are learning in this. So I know you in this, you have types. One is the positive interaction. Positive interaction, one of them is benefiting both the species A, species B. Okay, both are benefited. That's called the positive interaction. Second is the negative interaction. Negative interaction means one of them will be positive, one will be negative. Or both of them may be negative. Third one is neutral. Neutral in the sense, they will not be bothered, right? This also will not be benefited, this also will not be benefited. They'll be happily living together. This is called the negative, this is called a neutral interaction. They are not bothered. Are you able to follow this? Okay, fine, no issues. Right now, interspecific interaction in biotic community heading. Interspecific interaction in biotic communities. Are you writing? Do you write the heading? Interspecific interaction between biotic communities. In biotic communities. Right now. Different species of different population. Different species of different population normally interact interact. That is, either they affect each other or they may not. Either they affect each other or they may not. Written, either they affect each other or they may not. The interaction between two species is based on three different factors. The interaction between two species is based on three factors. Three factors. First one, nature of food and mode of obtaining it. Nature of food and mode of obtaining it. Then, second one, type of space needed for their shelter. Type of space needed for their shelter. Thank you. Next, third one. Habits like aggregation and breeding. Habits like aggregation and breeding. Written. Write down types of interactions. Ma'am, can you repeat the factors? Okay, I repeat. First one, nature of food and the mode of getting it. Mode of getting it. Second one, the type of space needed for shelter. The type of ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಜಗಳ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ಇರೋದು ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾಗೂ ನೆರಳು ಬೇಕಲ್ವಾ ಬೇಸಿಗೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮರದ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಾಯಿ ಮರಿಗಳು ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಕಳೆದಾಡ್ತವೆ ಅಂತ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಗೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ Habits like aggregation and breeding. I repeated. Next heading, right? Types of interactions. Next, interaction of organisms may be within two species or several species. Interaction of organisms may be within two species or several species. ಎರಡೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ನೆರಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಮಲ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಈ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ಟೈಗರ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಚೀತಾಗಳಿಗೆ ಲಯನ್ಸ್ ಗಳಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಒಂದೇ ಜಾಗ ಬೇಕು ಕೂಲ್ ಜಾಗ ಬೇಕು ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತವೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಡದಾಡ್ಬೇಕಲ್ವಾ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೈಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮೇಬಿ ಎರಡೇ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ two species or several species interaction involves the food chains or food webs andre food chain alano interaction irutte food chains or food webs Thank you. food chains and food webs. Interactions are of three types. Positive interaction, negative interaction, neutral interaction. Write the three. Interactions are of three types. Positive interaction, negative interaction, and neutral interaction. Written, first you write positive interaction or beneficial interaction. In this, one or both the participants participating species are benefited. Okay, so one by one, just little I'll give you. Both athwa one athwa eradannu kuda benefit agirutte. Examples heltene. Okay, it's example I'll give you in detail later. For example, scavenging. Scavenging andre enu? Scavenging andre the acting of the bacteria on the dead and decaying matter. Scavenging, right? Next one, commensalism. I'll tell you all these later, one by one, because these are to be asked in examination. Next is proto-cooperation. Next one, mutualism. Okay. So this is about the positive interaction. Ille one scavenging alli eradunu use agutte. Yakandre scavenge madutallo clean madutte adu arthana. Commensalism is one is benefited, one is either harmed or not. I'll explain you separately. First you write the examples. Scavenging, commensalism, proto cooperation and mutualism are the examples. ಬರದ್ರ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ನೌ ಐ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟೆಡ್ ಸೊ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಒಂದು ಏನೂ ಆಗಿರಲ್ಲ ಓಕೆ So, negative interaction andre interaction one is harmed negative and the harmed one may be harmed or it is not worth nothing is going to happen to that that is called as a negative interaction okay write down negative interaction or antagonistic interaction antagonistic interaction antagonistic interaction one of the species harmed barikoli in this one of the species harmed and another one is unaffected Another one is unaffected. For example, amensalism. You will know detail of what they are saying. First, one to heading bar kodini. Amensalism, computation. predation and parasitism nim gothe ide parasitism allela ondanna innond tin badkoltane hagagi one species harm aage agutte guarantee okay parasitism next baradra you want me to repeat I repeat okay In this, one of the species is harmed and other remains unaffected. Other remains unaffected. For example, amensalism, computation, predation and parasitism okay written rumana I repeated next when you write neutral interaction in this neither species benefits nor it suffers neither species benefits nor it suffers andre harm illa enta illa one padi tam padi tavirtave anta neither species benefits nor suffers
then
okay so ಈಗ ಒಂದೊಂದೇ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಆಯ್ತಾ okay first one you write mutualism mutualism andre symbiosis anta okay one by one helkondu hogtini ivu thumba important nimge exam ge kvpy ku kuda sumar prashne barthe idralli adike chana kalthkoli artha maadkoli okay सिंपल सिंपल टर्म्स अर्थ मे कॉम्प्लिकेटेड ऐन ओके सो फर्स्ट वन म्यूचुअलिज्म इन वर्ड इदक्के सिंबायोसिस अंतारे अंद्रे लिविंग टुगेदर अंत सिंपल मीनिंग लिविंग टुगेदर विथ बेनिफिट्स फॉर बोथ ऑफ देम लिविंग टुगेदर एरडु ओटोटिगे ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹೊಂದ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಓಕೆ ರೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮ್ಯೂಚುಯಲಿಸಂ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಬಯೋಸಿಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಷನ್ both the interacting species get benefited in this type of interaction both the interacting species get benefited ಬರ್ದಾಯ್ತಾ ಬೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟೆಡ್ ದ ಟೂ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸಿಂಬಯಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೂ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟೆಡ್ are participating are called symbionts okay next paragraph mutualism is an association between two individuals of two species so it's a definition mutualism is an association between two individuals of two species right. in which both are benefited, both are benefited but they cannot live separately under natural conditions. Cannot live separately under natural conditions. Means what? They will have to be together only. One bit one dira kagala okay anta. One day separate badka kagala okay anta. They need another one for their benefit. Next. The two species are called mutualists. The two species are called mutualists. Okay, so example helikododa mutualism. Yeah, the example first one we are learning here, it is lichens. So lichens are those where there is a close association of algae and fungi. They live together, right? Suppose there is a plant on this, the algae will be there along with the fungi. Together they will be forming a patch. What happens? Algae is undergoing photosynthesis and provide the food for fungi. Fungi will be having tough covering and will protect it, as well as it will give the protection from the environmental problems, right? So they help each other. Okay, that's why it is a mutualism, or it is a symbiotic association. Sometimes symbiosis they separate it, but anyway, mutualism, this is the right thing. Yeah, both, that's also correct. Sanjana, you're right. Mycorrhiza and fungi, that's a pinus plant. Okay, right on. Lichens. A lichen consists of an algae and fungus living together. Algae and fungus living together in a mutualistic relationship. In a mutualistic relationship. The alga undergo photosynthesis, produce the food, and both will use this. Both will use this. Next point. The fungus being tough and gelatinous, the fungus being tough and gelatinous, protect the algae and provide water and minerals to it. I repeat, the fungus being tough and gelatinous protects the algae and supply water and minerals to it. Done. I repeated, Shweta. Did you finish writing? You want me to repeat again? Done. Okay. Next example two, you write. Example two, you have gotta that leguminous plants and rhizobium. Rhizobium gotalva. Rhizobium is what? Right? For nitrogen fixation, right? That is, rhizobium is a type of bacteria that forms a root nodules in legumes and helps to provide nitrogen fixation, right? Example two is rhizobium and leguminous roots or leguminous plants, okay? Leguminous plants. So whenever you observe the legumes, will have the roots like this on which particular bacteria will grow, forming root nodules. This root nodulous bacteria is nothing but rhizobium. This will produce and will fix the atmospheric nitrogen into NO2 and NO3, provide the plant nitrogen, and in turn it will get all that supply of food and water freely, right? So it is inside living somebody's house and helping them. Like imagine you people have gone to someone's house as a gift, as a guest, simply sitting, eating, sleeping and all, throwing the plates here and there, then you are very bad people. And if you go to their house and you help them and you also cook along with them and eat together, help each other, that is a mutualism. That is helping each other. So if at all you are going and harming them and you are making them worry about you, that is a bad thing, right? It's a negative thing, right? The same way here, this is a positive interaction where both of them are helping each other, okay? Right now, so this one also is there, Pinus also is there, so many are there, okay? One of the other examples I'm giving you. Right now, rhizobium and leguminous plants. The bacteria named Rhizobium leguminosarum. So bacteria has a name there. the bacteria rhizobium, its name is Rhizobium leguminosarum. The full name of the bacteria, Rhizobium leguminosarum. Lives in the root nodules of leguminous plants. Lives in the root nodules of leguminous plants. The bacteria fixes the nitrogen. By converting ammonium into NO2 or NO3, NO2 and NO3, and provide the plant required amino acids for protein synthesis. Providing amino acids for protein synthesis. Should I repeat? Repeat after plant requires. Plant requires a Rakshita, I never told you plant requires. I told that to provide, it converts ammonia. Ammonia into NO2 and NO3, and it provides the plant amino acids required for protein synthesis. Required for protein synthesis. Amino acids make a lot of protein synthesis. That help madatte. This helps the plant to grow in nitrogen-free soil. This provides the plant nitrogen in a poor soil also. provide nitrogen in poor soil. In turn, bacteria get water, minerals. In turn, bacteria gets water, minerals, and organic food along with protection by the plant. In turn, bacteria gets water, minerals, organic food, and protection from plant. Aita, okay. One more animal example I'll give you. You will understand fully. It is the third example that is about mutualism. For mutualism, another very nice example we have. One is hermit crab and sea animal. Hermit crab and sea animal. Third example. Sea anemone and hermit crab. Okay, it's a very popular example actually. Sea anemone, I hope you have seen it. It will be somewhat like this. It belongs to Coelenterata. Okay, it will be having number of nematocysts like this. It's a sea anemone. This is the tentacles it has, right? Then it will have at one side the opening. To this, there is an attachment of a hermit crab. Okay. To this, there will be hermit crab. A small crab will be attached to this. Okay, this is a hermit crab which is attached to it with number of, fully it will be there attached to this. Okay, this is the hermit crab. Okay, they will be highly nicely associated with each other. Okay. Like this. This is the sea anemone. Sea anemone. And this is the hermit crab. Okay. They will be present together. And sea anemone will be having number of nematocysts. Nematocysts are the stinging cells. You know the stinging cells. So whenever any predator comes and act on this, this will produce the nematocysts and parasitize them. They will, it will get, it kills them or it will protect this. By producing nematocysts. So what happens? The predators will not attack the crab. Hermit crab will be happily eating some food and all. Always will be traveling, free travel. And in that it will eat something. Whatever food particles it will leave, this will eat it. That way both of them are benefiting each other. The hermit crab is aware of the particles. This is the major work of the or major type of symbiosis between both of them. Mutualism. One of them help. Arthaita, did you understand this? It's a very nice thing to know it also. Sea animal. Okay? Okay, write the heading, sea animal and hermit crab. Small diagram if you want, you draw. ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಬರೆದ್ರ ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್ ನ Done. 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 Drawing. Okay. Write down. See animal. See animal. So biological name is Tina, no? Adam Sia. ಅದರ ನೇಮ್ ನೆನ್ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಡಿ, ಬಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ನೇಮ್ ಅಡಮ್ಸಿಯ ಪಲ್ಲಿಕಾಟ. ಪೆಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಪಲ್ಲಿಕಾಟ. ಅದು ತಮಿಳು ಹೆಸರು ಇದ್ದಂಗಿದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ನಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ತಮಿಳು ನನಗೂ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಹಂಗೇನೋ ಒಂಥರ ಕಟ್ಟಪಟ್ಟ ಅಂತಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ, ಎನಿಬಡಿ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ತಮಿಳ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್. ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ತಮಿಳ್, ತೆಲುಗು, ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಪಲ್ಲಿಕಟ್ಟ. ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಪೆಡಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್. ಪೆಡಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್, ಪೆಡಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಕಾಲಿನತ್ರ ಒಂದು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ, ಪೆಡಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್. ಟು ವಿಚ್ ಅ ಸ್ನೇಲ್ shell is attached. Snail shell is attached. And it's normally a hermit crab.
hermit crab is attached. Write in the bracket its name. Eupagurus hermit crab is name andre. Eupagurus Predoxy. Predoxy. Predoxy or Predoxy. Hermit crab biological name is Eupagurus Predoxy. Predoxy. Next point. The sea animal protect the crab from enemies. The sea animal protect the crab from sea from the enemies. Enemies with its nematocysts. With its nematocysts. Nematocyst spelling barutalva nimge. With its nematocysts. In return, it receives the food pieces. It receives the food pieces dropped by the hermit crab. And it is carried to different places. It is carried to different places. Andre, the hermit crab nelladalli iruthe snail idu. It actually separate ag nodidre hing snail iruthe tale melindu hig iruthe. Idra olagade inda ee tara bandirthe hermit crab idu. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಇದ್ರ ತಲೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಇದು. ಓಕೆ, ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಸಿಲಿಂಡರ್ ಐಟ ಇದು ಸಿಲಿಂಡರ್ ಐಟ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಇದು ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ. ಸೊ ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೋ ಇದು ಆರಾಮಾಗಿ ಫ್ರೀಯಾಗಿ ಹೋಮ್ ಇದ್ರ ತರ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಓಡಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಹರ್ಮಿಟ್ ಕ್ರಾಬ್ ನೀರಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಂಗೆ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಟ ಆಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೈಟ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ. Are you getting the idea? It's like a portable home for that. Arthakta idya helado hermit crab adu olagade serkonbitide nan bardiru chittadalli. Actually adku nange disk irutte disk mele kuntirthade idu yado sea animal ellelle hogutto hermit crab idike free traveling along with that uta sigutte idu enen thing bitirathalla adu thikkontade. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಎರಡು ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಆರ್ ಯು ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್? ಇವೆರಡರಲ್ಲೂ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೊಂದ್ಕೊಂತದೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಆರ್ ಯು ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು? ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಸಿ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಡ್ ಟು ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್. ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಬದಲಾಗಿ ಇದೇನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಹರ್ಮಿಟ್ ಕ್ರಾಬ್ ಅನ್ನ ಶೆಲ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಸಿ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ದ ಪೀಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫುಡ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕ್ರಾಬ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಟು ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್. Then all of you. Another one you can give, that is about the flower and insect which we have discussed earlier. Yarandre nam euphorbia the fruit idella fig nepidya fig fig olagadene pollination aagbekandre insects beku. Insects, yes, good. Insects beku andre insect ge it has to feed this, right? And last one example, you only write this flowers and insects. Insect pollinating flowers. Always depend on insects for the transfer of pollen grains. Insects and flowers, right? Now, insect pollinating flowers always depend on insects for pollination. It is the best example of animal plant mutualism. It is the best example of animal plant mutualism. In this, insects get nectar and pollen grains as their food. Nectar and pollen grains as their food. And plants get cross-pollination with the help of insects. With the help of insects. Okay. So one more bekare fig do baribodu id regular pollen grains helidane no fig example baridre adanna now hesaru plant hesaru baritini naale nenapisidre nan fig do hesaru kodtini fig ge enuntare biologically amale aa insect hesaru yavudu anta separate aagi kodtini fig dalli artha aita. So is time up anset alva time aita टाइम आगोयता निम क्लास दो हेलो ओके फाइन बट दैट आई हैव टू गिव अ डायग्राम ऑफ द फिग आल्सो फिग डायग्राम बरीबेक मत्ते अदक्के टाइम तगोतदे ओके सी यू देन टुमारो टुमारो ला डे आफ्टर टुमारो सेम टाइम ओके फाइन बाय बाय सी यू बाय चिल्ड्रन.